Now we take this example, second example, for explaining the DE algorithm. This is the circuit. This is again taken from Stanley Hurst book. So this is what we are having as the circuit. Now in this, let's say this is the point at which we want to detect the fault. Now it is actually what? NOR gate is there. So NOR gate is there, which means it is a complemented output. So I want to check it stuck at zero fault, stuck at one fault at this point. So I assume, so first thing is I am choosing my site. So as given by the algorithm, we can check it side by side. The first is to select the site. So this is the site. Okay. The fault is stuck at one. Then I choose the primitive cube. The primitive cube in this case is this NOR gate. So in this NOR gate, since it is the complemented output, I choose or I sensitize my value to be D complement. So this is the sensitization. Once the sensitization is done, I move to the next step, that is propagation. So I propagate this D value to this path which is being followed. It goes to the G4 AND gate. So I know one of the input is D bar. Now, AND gate is having no, there is no complemented output. So I expect the output to be passed in the terms of D logic as D complement only. So I identify this value D complement here, but from my D drive logic, I know that if the output has to be D bar and the one of the input is D bar, for the AND gate, the other input should be always 1. So my propagation, I am able to determine certain values. So I again make the table for that. I have taken all the primary inputs as A, B, C, D, E, F, and rest of the points I have taken as 7, 8, 9. I have numbered them 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So I have put them in my table here. Okay. So at the step 1, what I was able to determine was 0.7. That is the fault site was determined to be D complement. Okay. For that D complement, what is the the inputs also had to be determined at this point. So what I require both the inputs should have been 1. So both the inputs D and E, which are coming to this gate, they are 1 for the output to be D complement. So these are determinable. Now where they are going to G4, what we are able to determine is 0.9. So 0.9 is D complement. And for this to be D complement, I want the other value to be 1. So my 8, this output of G2, that 0.88 is also determined to be 1. So in step 1, I am able to determine these logic values at these nodes in my circuit. Coming to step 4. Now here we are having a fanout. The typical value which I was talking about in the algorithm. So at fanout, I have two paths. I will have to choose with any one path which would be serving as my test cube, and the other would be my another cube. So I will have to take the intersection to justify the values. So I start with this path which is going to G5 to go towards the output. So for G5, it is actually what? It is a NOR gate again. So for this output to be propagated as NOR gate, what do I need to have? If this is D bar which is coming here, the complemented output because of this not present here should be D. So at 0.11, I am able to determine what is the value of the logic, that is D. But for this to be D, the second input has to be 0. So at 0.10, I am able to determine the logic value, that is 0. If this is to be 0, I need to determine what input is coming to this. So at least one of the input, let's say it is A, that should be 0. So I specify that to be 0. Okay. So in using this path, I have been able to identify these logic values. Now coming to the other cube of this fanout, G6, I again do that same logic propagation. D complement comes here. Since no complement is present in this gate, the output at point 12 would be D complement only. But this is an AND gate. For this D complement to be propagated at the output, the other input should be 1. And this is nothing but coming as primary input F. So my F is determined to be 1. Okay. So I am able to determine this at my step 3. Okay. Now coming to check the consistency, what we are left with is, now at this point I handle logic 1. So this to be having logic 1, at least one of the input should be 1. So let's say I put D input as 1. So D is 1, E is 1, F is 1. Now B and C, which are coming to both these gates, even if I put 0, that is working for me. So I put B and C as 0. So ultimately I am able to identify this input vector which is used to detect the stuck at 1 fault at point 7 in my circuit, and this can be, this would be A bar, B bar, C bar, D, E, F. So this is how D algorithm has been able to identify the test vector for the particular circuit.